everyone, this is Karaleise, and today we're going to be doing something just a little bit different. Today I'm going to be going through my emails and my messages. I'm going to be answering some questions that you guys have sent me and I've probably been waiting for a long time. So I will confess that I am behind on my emails and my messages. So y'all have been hitting me up on Facebook, on Instagram, on my email, and I have not been able to get back to each of you guys as fast as I would like. I am about 4 or 5 weeks behind, so yeah. I mean, there's a lot going on, and y'all have some serious questions. Like, I have emails that are this long and with many bullet points, and it's like really in-depth, serious questions, so I can't just give you a quick answer. I have to think about it. I have to like help you to get to the right conclusion. So there's a lot of mental work that goes in it, and I have a lot of other things going on. So I'm not giving you excuses. I'm just saying I apologize for the late responses to my emails, but it's just the way it is right now. I will when I can. All right, but today I'm going to give you an answer, and this video is going to be very, very insightful. I'm going to answer a lot of questions that newbie business analysts are burning and dying to know. So stay with me. I will be right back. Here is the email that I got from one of my subscribers. Let me just plug my mic in so my sound can be good. Yeah. So here's the email I got from my subscriber, and he says, "Hi, Kara. I am a recent university grad. I studied computer science and applied mathematics. Impressive. I graduated last year. I have been considering a job that does not require too much coding. After a lot of research, I felt the job position of a systems analyst well aligned with what I am good in. Unfortunately, when I check on LinkedIn, Glassdoor, and Indeed, etc., I notice that positions of systems analysts hardly come. I rarely see the job position. When I search for systems analyst, what I always see come up is business analyst. This oftentimes creates confusion as to whether both system and business analysts are the same. When I look at the job for business analysts, I always notice most of this job often requires certification, such as business analyst and a long list of certification. Also, long list of software that require you to be familiar with such as Jira, etc. Also, most of them require between 3 and 5 years of experience, which I do not have, obviously, because I just left school. The pandemic situation has even made matters worse to the point that I notice a lot of employers ask for very irrelevant things in their job requirements. So far, I have had 3 job interviews with no offers." Well, for that reason, below are a few questions I would like to ask you for an entry-level position. So the first question he has, and he has a lot, let's see. He has 11 questions. So, and these are loaded questions. So I'm gonna make a video for each of those questions, because if I try to answer it all in one video, we'll be here the whole night. So the first question he had is business and systems analyst the same? If not, what is the core difference? So, yeah. So business analysts and systems analysts are not the same, for sure. There are differences. But let me go back to the whole job hunt situation. So I definitely can empathize and feel the pain of this, because I have been going through this when I was just graduating from college. I came out of college. I had all this knowledge, right? I studied hard. I got good grades. I feel like I knew a lot about the things I studied. But how do you apply any of it? And how do you know which field to go into? I felt lost, honestly. When I came out, I was like, okay, I have all this information. I have these degrees. Now what? I know what I came across? Certifications. I'm like, I just spent all this money to get this education. And you're going to tell me I need to go do more courses just to be certified so I can get a job? Are you kidding me? So I was very put off by the whole certification thing. And I'm going to answer that question later because I think he has a question in here specifically about certification. But that was my first eye-opener. Like, okay, so all that money I just spent was for what reason? So that I could come on and spend even more money getting certified. And I didn't know if that meant that what I learned wasn't applicable, or it just confused me a lot. I was very confused as to the certification versus degree route. And also I didn't know which field I should be going into, especially when you study something like ComSci and applied mathematics, where it's such a great thing for you, for your thought process, right? It helps you to become so logical. And you can take a big problem and break it down to small pieces and solve the bottom pieces and get back to the solution at the top. It's a great field, but then what do you do with it? Like, what's your career path when you're done? So I definitely understand that struggle. And I would say, though, that business analysts and systems analysts are definitely different. And I understand why you're not seeing as much systems analyst job out there, because this is the history of the systems analyst. Back in the day, when everything was heavily waterfall, and if you watch the video I have on software development lifecycle, which I'm going to put right here, that kind of gives you the background of, you know, building software and how that came about in the cycle and the, you know, how the different phases are. But along those phases, the systems analyst used to play a big role because everybody was waterfall back in the day. Everybody was waterfall. They were all heavy documentation. So the project manager would have some scope, and then that scope would feed on to the business analyst who would write requirements at the business level. And then in some organizations, you had a systems analyst that would take those requirements from the business analyst or the project manager and break them down even further to be more easy to code. So for example, they would take a requirement and they would create entity relationship diagrams, they'd create class diagrams of how the data should be structured, they do the architectural designs and stuff like that, so that when the developer gets it, he knows exactly where to go, what fields are, what they should be called. He's very familiar with it because the systems analyst already fleshed out all of that for him already. But that was a lot of documentation, right? And it did add some more time to the project. So what happened to the systems analyst was Agile happened, right? Agile happened in the early 2000s, and even before that, back in the 90s, what happened was people are moving faster. You know, development and technology is going up, churning up faster, and we can't spend all this time documenting things when there's money to be made by getting it to market. So eventually, the role of the systems analyst started to taper off, and the need for the job was still there, but different people were now doing it. They didn't have a dedicated resource to systems analysis as they used to. So the business analyst was doing some of it, the project manager was doing some of it, the programmer themselves were doing some of it, architects were doing some of it. So it kind of, and companies want to make the most money, right? So if they can get rid of a role and have other people kind of do it, that would be like beneficial because they save money on that employee's salary and all that stuff. So eventually the systems analyst job kind of tapered off. And kind of got replaced by this, the business analyst. So now business analysts are writing requirements that are easier to get from requirements to code, like from business level to code with all these different formats, use a story format, all this stuff. So the need for the systems analyst has diminished. Now, if you work in a very large company that has very complicated systems, you might still find that there are some that still hire systems analysts because of the volume of whatever they're doing, or the size of their company, the hold it is, or kind of methodology they're using. Like, there are still jobs for systems analysts, don't get me wrong, but I would not encourage a new graduate to look into the systems analyst role because it's fast declining, right? It's not promising for the future. So I would not encourage you to start off in that field. Now, business analysts may not be for you either. So watch that video here that talks about, is the business analyst role right for you, right? You want to do something you're going to be happy in, that you're going to enjoy, that you can use the knowledge that you have and grow with that knowledge and do something you love. So maybe you're better at, I don't know, software architecture, where you don't have to actually write code, but you can design the systems. Like if you work with a big company like, I don't know, AT&T, they design fiber networks and all this stuff. Nobody's writing the code for these things. They're just, you know, designing, they're drawing diagrams, they're doing the analysis, but they're not really writing code, but it's not systems analyst. It's more like a systems engineer, a systems architect, you know, so there are still those kinds of jobs. So maybe you want to look into networking kind of things. And of course, yes, for networking, you do need certifications. In networking, it actually makes sense to me because some of these network things are specific to the vendors. So you want to make sure you understand how the vendors' products work. So in a way, I could see where that makes sense. But if you don't, if you want to get, you know, into business analysis, I mean, I'm going to do a video on the certification. I don't think you need to have one, but you definitely need to understand the business analyst job function, job role, how it works, you know, what you're expected to do. And so I would encourage you to look into either of those two areas, because systems analyst and business analyst is not the same. I agree. And it's definitely two different disciplines, but one of them is on the rise, business analyst, and the other one is on the decline, systems analyst. So it wouldn't make sense for you, in my opinion, to chase after the systems analyst job role as a new graduate. All right. So anyway, that was my answer to this question. Please watch your other videos. I'm going to be answering some other questions he has here. So he has a lot more very interesting questions. Please watch my other videos. I'm going to answer every one of them. It's going to be helpful for you too. So I will see you then. Take care.